carried my side, and now you can.
And we're here again today celebrating the life of Laetitia Lynthine Beckles. I would just like to say one thing. Like a bird singing in the rain, let grateful memories survive in time of sorrow. As a well-spent day brings happy sleep, so a life well-used bring happy death. Many people will walk in and out of your life, but only true friends leave footprints in your heart. And I can see from this morning that Laetitia, the Rastawoman as they call her, I can see the footprints that she has left in the hearts of so many people that's here. I would like to, I would like to bring on the hymn. Start with the hymn, Amazing Grace.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. 'Twas grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear the hour I first believed. When we've been there 10,000 years, Christ shining at the sun, we've no less days to sing God's praise than when we first begun. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see.
Now the words of remembrance from family members.
Hi, good morning. While the pain of losing mommy is incomparable, I can't help but find a strange parallel in the unexpected heaviness of my heart and some tears in my eyes, much like the weight I felt when I first tried on false eyelashes. Both experiences remind me of the intricate balance between beauty and sorrow in life, where even the smallest moments can carry unexpected significance. Today we gather to celebrate the life of my mother, a woman whose presence illuminated our lives and whose legacy will forever inspire us. As we reflect on her journey, we are filled with gratitude for the countless ways she touched our hearts and shaped our lives. In all of us, she has left a piece of her. She's left a piece of her in all of us. Mommy was a woman of quiet pride, but not so much when it came to her grandchildren, Xaria and Zachary. She was pretty vocal about them, and she took immense satisfaction in their achievements and accomplishments. And if you know my mother, Zari and Zach, apple of her eyes. She was a pioneer and a trailblazer for almost four decades, and I'll tell you why. She started out in Swan Street, and then she moved to James Street. She went to Temple Yard, finally Cheapside, and I don't mean the Cheapside you see nowhere, you know, there's the market. I'm talking about Cheapside, where there were stalls and the kiosks lined off, you know? And I would say mommy was a staple for all of us, a staple as it related to family, a staple as it related to her business. She just was always there. Mommy was fierce and fearless. She approached life with courage and tenacity. She faced adversity with a steely resolve, refused to be deterred by any challenges or setbacks. She carved her own path in life. She disliked injustices, particularly when it pertained to family. She was never one to back down or shy away. She will always tell it like it is. Don't feel no way. You know mommy will tell you like it is. Just don't feel any way about it. But she had to speak her mind. I, along with many others, can attest to this. There was this high level of unwavering loyalty, support, commitment, both directly and indirectly, as it pertained to the professional and personal relationship between her and daddy. They were definitely an A team. They could and they would talk, discuss, and debate any topic under the sun for hours and hours. When it came to the kitchen, I was truly amazed at how she could produce such delightful flavors from various herbs and spices. And a few of you would know that my name, what it means. The kitchen would be filled with the tantalizing aromas from her creations. And one of my favorite dishes that she made would have been Jamaican ackee and saltfish. And she wasn't a Jamaican. As I said, she was a constant staple. She was also a consistently hardworking entrepreneur. Passion and perseverance drove those in entrepreneurial spirits. Her tireless efforts paved the way for her success. Through these, you would have been sure to find her time and time again at events such as Oisin Swiss Festival, Bridgetown Market. You can even go further back to the conga line days in Dover. She has even been at events such as AgriFest, Whole Town Festival, Reggae on the Hill. Though mommy may not be here with us any longer, her spirit remains a guiding force. In closing, let us remember her not with sorrow, but with gratitude for the time we were blessed to spend in her presence. Though she may no longer walk with us, her spirit lives on in the memories we cherish and the life she touched. May we honor her legacy with these words. She would always say and absolutely mean, give thanks. Just give thanks. I implore each and every one of you to give thanks for all that is and all that is to come. For when thanks is given, you will be happier and more at peace. Thank you.
Morning. My dear sister, God have called you home a bit early and too soon, as many may say. As we gather today to cherish the memories what we were as sisters, I look back on our lives coming up in which we were 2 years apart, but yet still like twins. When you saw Laetitia, you saw me. And most of all, our friends were the same until our early 20s, when we thought we needed to have our own separate identities. My sister was a very strong person. Her beliefs and what she stood for, I always would say her bark was bigger than her bite. She would bleed in her heart but love you from a distance. When I migrated to the US in 2003, and I needed someone to take care of my two daughters, as much as we were estranged at that time, she stepped up and did it. And that, I must say, I am so grateful. Words cannot explain. As the years went by, we would talk and see each other on her trips to restock her business. The most memorable trip I can remember was when our uncle died in Canada, and she made that trip to New York and that 12-hour drive back and forth from Canada. We talk about our families and most of all, some of the decisions that I had made then and was making, some of the decisions I had made back then and some that I was making in my life at the moment. And she encouraged me, and that I did take heed. Today at this time, Moses, Fennel, Yomi, Zachary, and Xaria, I can say y'all were truly loved by her. As your baby sister, as I kept our memories close in my heart always, I know I had a special place in which you had loved me. I can't do it anymore.
Good morning, family and friends. Together, we will journey back to the very intriguing school days of Laetitia. And so first, we have to set the scene for maximum effect, right? 1981, Combermere School, Waterford Bottom. 8 eager schoolgirls ready to turn things up and run the school in the way that we wanted to run it. We were on a mission that had absolutely nothing to do with taking any instructions from any teacher in Combermere. It is September 1981, beginning of a new school year. Everyone is excited because we are entering fourth form, 4A. We are seniors, so you know we are looking sharp in our uniforms, white skirts, white blouses, gray skirts, black shoes, white socks, of course, our epaulettes and ties. Big girl hairdos, it was the 80s, windbreakers, that's jackets for those who don't remember, books, pens, but most significantly, It was the meeting of 8 new friends. For the 8 of us, it was the forming of the Soul Sisters. It was Allison Lynch, Charmaine Hunt, Marcia Levine, Maria Annell, Savitri Singh Odo, Sherry Brathwaite, Sonia Workman, and Laetitia Beckles. And that's who we were. We were always together, chatting, laughing, playing pranks with each other and on others. And should any of those pranks that we played on others backfired, our dear friend Laetitia was always upfront to boldly defend any of us. More so Sherry, because she was always getting into something and she always sought Laetitia's help to deal with the enemies. And Laetitia was always willing to accept and to help Sherry out. For me, I was always trying to be some type of an activist, having thoughts about insurrection and how to change something or the other and how we could deal with the math teacher who couldn't teach and you know, how we could change the relevance of Mark Twain and how irrelevant that was within the current environment and those sorts of things. And Laetitia is the only soul sister of the other 7 that I could always turn to. And I would always try to engage her in this plan of revolution, you know? And she would listen and she would nod and when I would go full commando, she would add a few words there but the older I got and as the friendship developed, I realized that she was just humoring me. But Laetitia was a strong individual and never backed down from her point of view. So strong were her beliefs that she fought with the toughest at school. And we looked up to her. Under her toughness, she displayed exemplary gifts of kindness, sharing, and humbleness. Laetitia was a woman of the soil, beautiful inside and out. Her presence could be felt in any room, any place in the school, and there was no pretense with her at all. She was genuine, she was real, and she was natural. And all of that was evident in her smile. Those years were fun times. We had nothing to worry about but laugh, chat, enjoy life, and just be mischievous. Many a day, Laetitia would sit in the back of the class, her head resting comfortably on the desk. Her blue and white rim breaker and her red Lee Cooper bag would suffice as a pillow, and she would be sound asleep, sometimes snoring loudly. That was usually a big joke for us. It was a hoot for us. Just yesterday, Savitri was reminding me of the gold tooth saga. So Laetitia had this gold tooth that disappeared when she went to sleep. And she had no idea what happened to the gold tooth, but it was missing. And where it went was a mystery to her. But the interesting thing about the gold tooth is that she wasn't fazed by this missing tooth. She was that type of person. She didn't know where it went, and she was not about to dwell on that. So she was that person, no drama, no stress. What most people didn't know about Laetitia is that she was extremely intelligent, though, and she knew how to use her mind economically. She wasn't interested in absorbing irrelevant academics that had no bearing on what she was about to do. But when something sparked her interest, you could see the intellect. She would lock in and it would just emerge. While the rest of us would always be engaged in silly schoolgirl drama, gossip, and confusion. It was always confusion. Laetitia was mostly on her own beat and what we would call at that time her Rasta things. She didn't have any time for foolishness, and she would be present just observing with a smile. Like you all could really relax, because if it was one thing that the Soul Sisters knew how to do, was to take it real fast from 1 to 100. But Laetitia was always there, like that stabilizing force, very practical, no judgment, and it was really easy to be her friend. I remember we would leave school on evenings, and while Sonia, Sherry, and I would go to Norman Center to visit the boutiques to look at sarsaparilla jeans and other fashion, Laetitia would wander off to this place between Cape Shepherd and Norman Center. What was that? Rocker's Alley. Rocker's Alley, right. And that was where there was a Rasta community setting stuff. And then we would meet up with her afterwards, and we would follow her to Swan Street, where her friends Effie and Jackie had a stall. We would then hang around there for a while, and then we would make our way to the Lower Green bus stand. And I think, though, Laetitia had the most street sense of all of us. But those were the good days. Life was simple. Anyhow, as the years rolled by, and as life would be, we drifted apart to take responsibility for our respective lives. Contact with each other became infrequent. A few years later, we reconnected thanks to technology, email, WhatsApp, Facebook. Laetitia's love and kindness extended to our children and grandchildren. She was always quick to inquire about our loved ones and quicker to offer them gifts. We will always remember her kindness and gestures. Thank you, Laetitia. As we reminisce, we thank God foremost for connecting and directing the paths of 8 girls who kept a friendship burning for over 40 years. And we will continue to do so until we meet on the other side. Laetitia, we love you and we miss you dearly. To Moses, Fennel, Yomi, family and friends, cherish the moments and memories of Laetitia, and may God's comfort and peace be with you all. I'm Charmaine. Thank you for listening. And I just want to take 1 minute to introduce the rest of the Soul Sisters. Sherry, stand up so the people could see you. Savvy, Allison, Marcia. I thank you.
Beautiful. I could tell you that Charmaine, I don't know the rest of the Soul Sisters, but I could tell you that Charmaine is still rebellious. So we're bringing on the songs rendered by Aishakia McNeil. Tribute in song. That's you? Oh.
Good morning, everybody. It is a sad day. We want to celebrate the life of Laetitia. When Fennel had spoken to me, she said her mother was a fan of Bob Marley. And this morning, I'm going to do Redemption Song. And I hope you all enjoy it. Old pirates, yes, they rob I, sold I to the merchant ships. Minutes after they took I from the bottomless pits, but my head was made strong by the hands of the Almighty. We forward in this generation triumphantly. Won't you help to sing these songs of freedom? Is all I ever had, redemption songs, redemption songs. Emancipate yourselves from mental slavery. None but ourselves can free our minds. Have no fear for atomic energy, 'cause none of them can stop the tide. How long shall we kill our prophets while we stand aside and look? Ooh, some say it's just a part of it. We've got to fulfill the book. Won't you help to sing these songs of freedom? Is all I ever had, redemption song. Redemption songs. Emancipate yourselves from mental slavery. None but ourselves can free our minds. Have no fear for atomic energy, 'cause none of them can stop the tide. How long shall they kill our prophets while we stand aside and look? Ooh, some say he's just a part of it. We've got to fulfill the book. Won't you help me sing these songs of freedom? Is all I ever had. Redemption songs is all I ever had. Redemption songs is all I ever had. Redemption songs.
Redemption song. We're not bringing up Xaria Holder.
Good morning. My name is Yomi Moseley. I have switched with my niece Xaria Holder in the Psalms. Psalm 46. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear, though the earth shall change, through the mountains shake in the hearts of the sea. Though waters roar and foam, through the mountains tremble with its tumult, there's a river whose streams make glad the city of God, the holy habitation of the Most High. God is the midst of the city. It shall not be moved. God will help it when the morning dawns. The nations are in an uproar. The kingdoms totter. He utters his voice and earth melts. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. Come, behold the words of the Lord. So what desolations he has brought on this earth. It makes wars cease to the end of the earth. He breaks the bow and shatters the spear. He burns the shields with fire. Be still and know that I am God. I am exalted among the nations. I am exalted in the earth. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. Amen. Thank you.
Onika. We'll have a tribute with drumming by Onika.
Greetings and salutations. I am Onika, Queen of the Drum, and it is a pleasure and a blessing to be here for my sister. And I will be doing a drumology from my father, Alvaro del Congo, called Let Us In. It's actually fitting for this environment because it's saying Let Us In. Thank you. Thank you. letters in the night. Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.
Yomi, you reading these Psalms? Huh? Oh, there too.
This morning's Bible reading will be taken from Psalms 23. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pasture. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. And I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
Then we have the hymn, When the Roll is Called Up Yonder. Stand, sing the song.
Save the birds shall gather over on the other shore, and the roll is called up yonder. I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. The skies and the road is all of yonder eyes.
master from the dawn to setting sun. Let us talk of all his wondrous love and care. Then when all of life is over and our work on earth is done, and the road is tall up yonder, I'll be there.
You may see. Now we have Bongo Lights come up and with the closing statement.
Good day, everyone. Beautiful day. Sunshine. I wrote a poem here for Laetitia. I wrote it, yeah, this morning, wrote it. I just want to share how the poem came about. When Moses had asked me, you know, to be partake of this, I went to the spirit world. I got up around 3 o'clock in the morning and I asked Laetitia, so what am I going to do for you? And I could see her smiling there at me and it's like, do you think? So this is my thing I'm doing for her, like she said. We celebrate the life of Laetitia, a family, a friend, a Rasta. She served the Rasta community, selling clothes and jewelry. She kept the cultural identity. She stood by her Rasta king for 40 years and stood with him through blood, sweat, and tears. She stood in relation before the separation. To this, I give her a standing ovation. Now that her work on earth has done, and her words may be simple to some, we congrats for building the Rasta family and stood in the fold of Rasta reality. While others were running away, she hold fast and she stay. As a woman, she stood humble to Rasta. It's a good example. We thank you for the time you spent with us. Good memories of you will always be discussed. We thank you for standing firm. Your blessings and respect you have earned. Thank you.
I've always tell my brethren Bongo Lights that we always talk about this, that, you know, sometimes we don't think about death in the sense that we have to go. We don't think about that, and it's life is so short, is between birth and death. Is what you do in between that time period that makes a difference. It's not the transitioning of the body itself, because the body and the spirit, her, Laetitia's spirit, is still with us. The body itself goes back to the earth, which the earth claims it. But We need to think more about living and how we live. I mean, Laetitia should be an example. I mean, everybody that came up here, from her children to people that know her, you know, they just, and her family members, all spoke highly about the life that she lived, the life that she lived. And we too, you know, death is a reminder to the living. Death is a reminder to the living that your time too is short, and is what you do with that time that makes a difference. And we shouldn't have to wait until a person passes away to show them love, because they can't feel it anymore. They can't hear that I love you anymore. They can't hear that, you know, they can't feel that those hugs anymore. So we should supposed to deal with each other while we are alive, show that love. Show that love when we're alive, and not when the person is no longer here. And this is something that I'm thankful to be here, and I'm thankful that Brother Moses invited myself and Bonga Lights, you know, to here. And I, as I said, the sister, let this be a reminder to all of us that sit in here that life is not permanent. And at some point, all of us that sit in here have a date. And that date, before that date comes, is what you do before that date arrives that makes a difference. So thank you. Yeah, God bless you.